Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with all of you. As we gather to celebrate the Eucharist today, we pause. We ask Jesus to forgive us our sins.
Lord Jesus, you came to live among us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you show us the way to the Father in heaven. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you will come again in glory with salvation for your people. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. God of might and giver of every good gift, put into our hearts the love of your name, so that by deepening our sense of reverence, you may nurture in us what is good, and by your watchful care, keep safe what you have nurtured. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, I could not talk to you as spiritual people, but as fleshly people, as infants in Christ. I fed you milk, not solid food, because you were unable to take it. Indeed, you are still not able, even now, for you are still of the flesh. While there is jealousy and rivalry among you, are you not of the flesh and walking according to the manner of man? Whenever someone says, I belong to Paul, and another, I belong to Apollos, are you not merely men? What is Apollos, after all, and what is Paul? Ministers through whom you became believers, just as the Lord assigned each one. I planted, Apollos watered, but God caused the growth. Therefore, neither the one who plants nor the one who waters is anything, but only God who causes the growth. He who plants and he who waters are one, and each will receive wages in proportion to his labor. For we are God's co-workers. You are God's field, God's building. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Bless the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Bless the nation whose God is the Lord, the people he has chosen for his own inheritance. From heaven the Lord looks down. He sees all mankind.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
From his fixed throne he beholds all who dwell on the earth. He who fashioned the heart of each, he who knows all their works.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
Our soul waits for the Lord, who is our help and our shield. For in him our hearts rejoice. In his holy name we trust.
Blessed the people the Lord has chosen to be his own.
And on your lips.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Sing his message loud and clear, hallelujah. Jesus Christ our Lord is near,
hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After Jesus left the synagogue, he entered the house of Simon. Simon's mother-in-law was afflicted with a severe fever, and they interceded with him about her. He stood over her, rebuked the fever, and it left her. She got up immediately and waited on them. At sunset, all who had people sick with various diseases brought them to him. He laid his hands on each of them and cured them. And demons also came out from many, shouting, "You are the Son of God." But he rebuked them and did not allow them to speak, because they knew that he was the Christ. At daybreak, Jesus left and went into a deserted place. The crowds went looking for him, and when they came to him, they tried to prevent him from leaving. But he said to them, "To the other towns also I must proclaim the good news of the kingdom of God, because of this purpose I have been sent." And he was preaching in the synagogues of Judea. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Jesus Christ. If you've ever been to Rome, or if you ever plan to go to Rome, probably the four major churches that you will see are St. Peter's Basilica. Probably the largest church in the world. It's so big it would cover our entire church, our parking lot, the school, probably the rectory, and then some. St. Paul outside of the walls was particularly big, a different style. St. Mary Major and St. John Lateran. All of them are enormous churches. If you go to St. John Lateran's church, on each side of the church, as you walk up the center aisle, are huge statues of the 12 apostles. They just tower way above you, probably as high as the center of our church here. Just enormous. And that's kind of the way we think of the 12 apostles. as being extraordinary disciples and certainly great saints, and they are. But if you read the Gospels, and the Gospel, one of the options today would have been the calling of the 12 apostles by Jesus, you would see that they're very ordinary men. They had a lot of hang-ups like you and I do. They were jealous of one another. Peter often, he was a leader, definitely, but oftentimes he said dumb things and people laughed at him. But that didn't stop him. A lot of times he said great things too. And Jesus complimented them for that. But he was definitely a leader. Andrew was a guy who was always mingling with the crowds. He was friendly with everybody and bringing people to Jesus. James and John, well, I don't know. They were kind of mama's boys. They wanted positions of honor in Jesus' kingdom. They sent their mom to ask the question in the favor of Jesus. Ordinary men. Matthew was a Jew who collected taxes from his own people for the Romans. Not a lot of people liked him. Simon the Zealot party member wanted to kill people like Matthew. Just a different group of people, and they all had their hang-ups like us. They all promised Jesus they would die with him at the Last Supper, but a few hours later they ran away and hid. Peter denied that he knew Jesus. Only John followed Jesus faithfully to the foot of the cross. But eventually, with the coming of the Holy Spirit, they become the great saints that they are. And what I find interesting about the fact that Jesus chose ordinary people to be his followers, he's choosing each one of us to be his disciples too. And it just amazes me how God loves to choose ordinary people like you and me, sometimes sinful people, to become his saints. God specializes in calling sinners to become saints, and that's true of every single one of us. We're all sinful people. But hopefully one day you'll all be in heaven. But you have to work to get there. You have to show your faith in Jesus. You have to turn to him often in prayer. And no matter what grade you are in grade school, or no matter how old you are, you might even be the oldest member of this parish. You still have work to do. Turn to God in prayer every day. Keep the commandments. Listen to your moms and dads. Listen to your teacher, study hard, try to get along with your brothers and sisters, although sometimes that's a pretty hard thing to do. These are the things we have to do every day in order to one day to become great saints in heaven. So today, as we honor the 12 apostles that Jesus called to be his disciples, we ask them to pray for us, that we will try to overcome our selfishness and sinfulness, always keep our focus on Jesus and follow him, so that one day, through his death and resurrection, we can become his great saints in heaven. So with that in mind, let's pray. Oh God, our Heavenly Father, help us to respond to the call of Jesus to be his disciples, so that one day he will invite us to the joys of his kingdom in heaven. Grant us this, Lord, and the favors we ask in Jesus' name.
For our Holy Father, Pope Francis, for Archbishop Lucas, Bishop Hanfeld, and Bishop Conley, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Let us pray for those who serve us in public office, that in times of crisis they will strive to work together for what is best for our country. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all families, that each member will show love and respect, patience and willingness to work together. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill, that they may experience God's healing power, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our departed loved ones, that they may know the joys of eternal life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For parents and teachers and children, that with the beginning of the new school year, we may begin to work back to some sense of normalcy, and kept free from COVID-19, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For more vocations, the priesthood and religious life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For more needed rain, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those things we hold in the silence of our hearts, We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Let's pray for Father Cliff Stevens. He'll be buried tomorrow in Omaha. Priest of the Archdiocese for many years. We pray for him to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we offer this Mass today for the living and deceased of the Buddy and the Ollie Lamp family. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
O God, our Father in heaven, please grant us these and all our needs, for which we pray to you today in Jesus' name, for he is Lord forever and ever. Chalice. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation. Through your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Lord God, we ask you to receive us and be pleased with the sacrifice we offer with humble and contrite hearts. Wash away my iniquity, cleanse me of my sins. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the sacred offering, O Lord, confer in us always the blessing of salvation, that what is celebrated in mystery, it may accomplish in power, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashion for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation, through Christ our Lord. Through him the hosts of angels adore your majesty and rejoice in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim. Heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. And therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord,
and profess your resurrection
until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by his death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with this Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Joseph, Saint Isidore, and with all your saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of a reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen,
amen,
amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, and by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with all of you.
And with your spirit. Share with one another a sign of Christ's peace.
take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. The body of Christ.
Our communion song is Worthy is the Lamb, which is number 575.
Are you?
Please join me in making a spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Renewed by this bread from the heavenly table, we beseech you, Lord, that being the food of charity, it may confirm our hearts and stir us to serve you and our neighbor through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and grant you his peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord by your works.
Thanks be to God.
As we go forth, join with us in number 385, City of God.
Awake from your slumber.
Life and mercy, a new day is dawning for all those who weep.
The people in darkness
have seen a great light. The Lord of all morning has found us tonight. Let us build the city of God. May our tears be turned into dancing. For the Lord, our light and our love, has turned the night into day.
Today's Morning Mass is brought to you in part by these sponsors.
Let us build the city of God.